And I also, like, don't love water a whole lot. I'm scared of it. It was one thing that attracted me to the movie.
How long can you hold your breath underwater? And can you guess which Avatar The Way of Water actress holds the Hollywood record for longest time spent holding her breath? These numbers are definitely going to shock you, so make sure you grab yourself a snack and let's get into it. Number 1. If you guessed Kate Winslet to be the record holder, you'd be right. For her role in Avatar The Way of Water, Kate held her breath for an astounding 7 minutes and 14 seconds. How did she do it?
Training. It's not something I could just jump in the bath and do right now.
Kate trained with a freediving instructor for about a year while she was working on the movie, and director James Cameron described her as being a natural in the water. Number 2. Mabel Cadena almost beat Kate Winslet's record. For her role in Black Panther, Wakanda Forever, Mabel trained underwater for a year, doing dolphin kicks, free dives, and maximizing her breath holds. Her record was nearly 7 minutes underwater.
What was 6.5?
Either way, co-star Alex Livinalli revealed that it was better than anyone else on the cast could do.
Like, no one even came close to her.
Cadena admitted that it was hard work, but said it was worth it to see it all pay off in the movie. Number 3. Can you swim? That was one of the first questions director Ryan Coogler had for Tenoch Huerta upon offering him the role of Namor in Black Panther Wakanda Forever. His answer?
I never drowned before.
This response may have got him through casting, but the truth was, Tenoch couldn't swim.
No, I don't know how to swim. Come on, man! You should say that, you know, because it's dangerous.
He had to undergo the same difficult training as Mabel Cadena, but in his case, he started on the basics. Eventually, Tenoch got to the point where he could hold his breath underwater for 6 minutes. Number 4. Add another thing to the list of reasons why Sigourney Weaver is awesome. She held her breath for 6 minutes on the set of Avatar, The Way of Water, partly by remaining completely still. Her freelance diving instructor also taught her to think of the urge to breathe as the dirty villain.
And you ignore the dirty villain, you go, ha, you, go away.
She would then do anything she could to keep her mind busy. Number 5. Isla Fisher thought it would be the end of her, filming Now You See Me. When her character climbs into a water tank, the handcuffs she was wearing were magnetic, but the chain wrapping around her wrists and ankles were secure. So when the chain wound beneath a slat, she was trapped.
I was banging and saying, you know, set me free, but everyone just thought I was doing fabulous acting.
Apparently, no one had prepared a safety signal that would alert anyone on set to any trouble. We're just glad she made it out alive. Number 6. Daniel Radcliffe wasn't too excited to have to swim as Harry Potter.
Swimming is my most hated of all things.
For the second challenge of the Triwizard Tournament in the Goblet of Fire, Daniel had to train in an on-set water tank for 6 months, something that left him with not one, but 2 ear infections. As much as he hated having to do it at the time, however, he looks back on it a bit more fondly now, having apparently come to realize,
I will never do that again.
Number 7. Kristen Stewart is terrified of swimming.
You're so subject to your environment that you're, like, kind of utterly helpless.
When she signed up for her role in Underwater, Kristen hadn't realized that she would be spending the majority of her time completely submerged in claustrophobic environments and wearing a 100-pound scuba suit.
This was absolutely horrible, like the worst experience I've ever had on a movie.
Kristen decided to skip scuba diving lessons altogether, apparently telling director William Eubank, just put me in the suit on the day, I don't care, it's going to be so awful. Number 8. Sam Worthington was given a warning. He admitted that he had a feeling free diving was going to feature in Avatar The Way of Water after James Cameron told him that was his hobby. Sam has said that the underwater scenes were the hardest thing he's done in his career, especially considering how emotional they were.
And you're doing scenes under there that are hard enough to do on dry land.
If you're wondering how he fared against his co-stars, Sam says that his record for holding his breath is
easily 15 seconds.
Number 9. You never know how someone's going to take to the water. Emily Blunt had never had to perform underwater before the Jungle Cruise, where she learned how to hold her breath for up to 30 seconds. The underwater cinematographer would say that working with Blunt was the highlight of the film for him, telling Insider, I really admire Emily's work in this. I had no idea what her comfort level was in the water. She was stone cold with her calmness. Number 10. Dwayne Johnson is no stranger to underwater stunts. For San Andreas, he had to spend plenty of time performing on a set flooded with water. When it came time for him to train for his underwater scenes in Jungle Cruise, underwater cinematographer Ian Seabrook was surprised by how naturally swimming came to him, saying, "When Dwayne took his first breaststroke, the first take he did ended up right on top of me." From that point forward, Seabrook had to work extra hard just to keep up. Number 11. Some find peace in the water. Take Daniel Craig, for instance, who, on the set of Skyfall, would sneak away between takes to nap at the bottom of the on-set water tank. Daniel described it as wonderful being in the water, and admitted that he'd hide down there for so long that he'd hear other members of the crew asking, "Where's Daniel?" His scuba diving experience definitely came in handy here, as well as the microphones the tank comes equipped with to better get the attention of underwater actors. Number 12. Do your nightmares include drowning?
Yeah, I'm sure it's gonna be quite scary.
Eva Green said that her underwater scene for Casino Royale felt exactly like a nightmare. Even though she spent plenty of time in rehearsals with a mouthpiece, she still wound up swallowing a lot of water.
It was quite scary at the beginning.
To make matters worse, although she had rehearsed the scene in clear water, on the actual day of filming, she discovered that the water was going to be murky, which only made it that much harder to see. Number 13. Is there a stunt Tom Cruise won't try? The underwater scene in Mission Impossible: Rogue Nation was filmed in one continuous shot, meaning that Tom Cruise needed to hold his breath on set for 6 minutes.
It's not pleasant.
He said his naturally low heart rate helped him, but he also trained with freedivers on ways to slow his heart rate even more. Apparently, Tom got so good at it that even in his day-to-day life, he'd suddenly realize he'd stop breathing.
And I had to turn my autonomic system back on to breathing it.
Number 14. It isn't all fun and games being a Kingsman. For the first movie, Taron Egerton trained to hold his breath for up to a minute and 20 seconds.
It's quite scary.
It's mentally quite.
And that isn't even the scariest part. On the first day of filming for the underwater scene, a computer malfunction caused the entire cast and crew to be dropped unexpectedly into around 20 feet of water. Director Matthew Vaughn would later describe the incident, saying, "Those actors weren't acting. They were absolutely terrified." Number 15. Do you have a competitive side? Margot Robbie does.
No one needs to drown over this.
On the set for Suicide Squad, she's competed with her stunt double to see who could hold their breath the longest. Margot tried to end the competition when she reached 5 resting minutes underwater, considering she'd already done better than she thought she could. But when her stunt double came back with 5.5 minutes, Margot tried to go again, prompting the studio to shut the competition down.
Dang. The scene takes 1 minute. You don't need to do this.
These actors had to go to some difficult extremes to get that perfect shot, and we love them all the more for it. Which underwater filming experience do you shudder the most to think about? Make sure to let us know down in the comments.